Oh, it's going down. Adonis Stevens just entered the ring with his cape on. It's about to go down, y'all. Main event. Adonis Stevenson is back. And he's in there. He's in there with a monster. Thomas Williams ain't no damn joke, y'all. Thomas Williams ain't no damn joke. Yeah, it was a majority draw. I fast-forwarded past the decision once I realized I was a little bit behind. No, I don't know. Nicholas, neither one of them were home fighters. Both of them was American. All right, y'all, it's going down. Main event. Adonis Stevenson, 10 years older than the young Thomas Top Dog Williams Jr. Top Dog Williams is a knockout artist. He's a knockout artist. I think he's knocked out his last four opponents. He just knocked out Edwin Rodriguez in his last fight. It's going down, guys. It's going down. This is a good-ass fight. This is a good-ass fight right here. I think Adonis will fight Kovalev. I think he will. I mean, there was a time when Kovalev, he was re, how should I put it? There was a time when his contract was coming up for renewal, and he had an option before he re-signed with Duva. He had an option to make a deal with Adonis Stevenson and fight him on maybe PBC, on Showtime, wherever, or he could just re-sign with Duva and you know, go and not take the Stevenson fight. Sorry, I got a little distracted over here. But basically what I'm trying to say, let me reiterate. Kovalev had an opportunity to either re-sign with Duva and not fight Stevenson, or fight Stevenson first and then re-sign with Duva afterwards. Kovalev, he decided to sign with Duva, and that's the reason why the fight didn't happen. Where does Stevenson go from here? Well, Brandon, if Stevenson wins this very tough fight right here, then he's going to have to fight against the undefeated Elite Alvarez. Elite Alvarez is even a tougher fight than this, because that guy, he just fought on the undercard. He's an undefeated fighter, and that would really be a tough fight. But this right here is a good 50-50 fight, guys. So here it go, guys. It's about, the bell's about to ring right now. Okay. They circling. The fight just started. Adonis Superman Stevenson against Thomas Top Dog Williams is going down, y'all. So right now, they both posing right now, and everybody, you know, both fighters filling each other out right now. You guys watching this fight? Rodriguez had him hurt. It then got reckless. Yeah, he did have him hurt. Alvarez, really? That's actually a good fight, actually. It'll be a dip. Styles make fights, remember that. If Adonis fights against the leader, Alvarez, it's going to be a different fight than what Alvarez fight was tonight against Robert Berich. Okay, guys, so nothing is going on right now. Okay, Adonis, he just threw his first left hand and he missed. Oh, Adonis just caught Williams with the left. I think Adonis is going to knock Williams out, guys. I think Adonis is going to knock him out. The thing right now is Williams is too, he's a little too telegraphed. See, yeah, oh, Adonis just landed a real quick left hand, and Williams tried to counter him with a right hook, but Williams missed. Right now, Adonis is looking good, y'all. He's looking real good. He keeps popping that jab out, real quick, stiff jabs. And now Williams is coming forward, and Adonis is throwing the jab. He keeps pumping that jab out. Real nice jab, guys. Real nice jab. Williams is coming in with the high guard right now, but Williams, he hasn't come close to landing anything. Hey, man, that left hand is looking good by Adonis. Oh, he just caught Williams with another left hand right now, guys. Williams can't get on. He said Williams can't get on the inside. Yeah, well, Williams is not really trying to get on the inside. Okay, well, I mean, Williams is leaping in with wild hooks. That's not how you're going to get on the inside. He got to bob and weave and kind of go side to side to get close to Adonis. That's not what Williams is doing. Adonis is looking good, guys. Adonis looks really, really good with his jab. I like the way, you know, he's using it. He's throwing it up and down. He's using feints. There it goes. There it goes. Just caught him with the left hand. He just knocked him down. I told you, man. I just told you guys right before the knockdown. I could see it in the first 10 seconds. Adonis was going to knock this dude out. He just knocked him down. Williams is back up now, guys. This is a wrap. As long as Stevenson doesn't get careless and run into anything. And look, see, Adonis is attacking. He's attacking in an intelligent way. Adonis, he realizes that Williams is still dangerous. So the round ends. So Williams makes it out of round one, but man, that was a nice knockdown. He caught him with a left hand that landed right over the ear, the right ear on the side of his head. Good shit, y'all. Good shit. Real good shit. The fight is on Spike TV. On Spike TV, if you have DirecTV Direct Dish or whatever, if you have Dish TV, it should be on channel 241. All right? Let me turn this damn TV down. It's a little too loud. Yeah, this is a good fight, guys. This is a real, real good fight, guys. It's a commercial right now, so I feel like I'm watching NBA right now. You know, getting past these commercials. Adonis is strong. Yeah, Wilton, Adonis is real strong. Not only is he strong, but his reflexes. Here's the replay. They're showing the replay. He caught him with a quick left hand. You know, Adonis, he when I see that left hand, Adonis, he reminds me of Manny Pacquiao with the left hand. Because you, no matter what flaws, you know, you point out when it comes to Adonis Stevens, it's like his left hand basically makes up for his flaws. But Adonis Stevenson, he doesn't really have a whole lot of flaws, though. He used to be left hand crazy like Pacquiao used to be, but now Adonis is looking more complete. And I'm going to tell you guys, before I didn't think, oh, he just caught him with another left hand. He just caught him with another left hand. He's about to dispose of this man, Thomas Williams. He just caught him with another left hand. And now Williams is backing up. He's slightly backing up. And Adonis is setting up the left hand again. He barely missed the third one. There's another left hand. And Williams blocked that one. William has the high guard right. Oh, he just landed one. Okay, now Williams is tapping his chin like, I just took your left hand. Okay, now, now Williams is coming back. He just caught Adonis with a good jab, two good jabs. Adonis kind of tied him up a little bit. Okay, here, let me see this. Let me turn this up a little bit over here. Hey, this is looking good, y'all. This is looking real good. Williams is going to be dangerous. Williams is going to be dangerous to the end of this fight. I can tell you that right now. Williams is going to be dangerous until he gets knocked out. He just caught Adonis with two right hooks, but Adonis didn't even budge. He just caught Adonis with two good right hooks. Adonis coming back with the jab. Now Adonis is controlling. He's controlling Williams again. Now Williams is circling. Williams just threw a nice little left hook to Adonis. Oh, they exchanged power shots. Adonis threw his left and nice little combination, little body combination by Williams. Hey, Williams is back in this fight, guys. Williams is back in this fight. It's a minute into the second round, and Williams, who basically has come back from a knockdown. Whoa, Williams just threw a hard ass right hook, but he missed. He's got Williams on the ropes. He got Williams on the ropes. He just caught Williams. He caught Adonis, excuse me, with a good hook. Hey, man, Adonis is showing a good chin because I thought he had Adonis hurt. He just backed Adonis up to the ropes, and he threw like a four-punch combination, nothing but power shots, hooks and uppercuts, and probably one or two shots got in. Okay, now Adonis is back in the center of the ring. Adonis is moving him back with his jab. I'm going to tell you guys something. What I just seen right now, it gives me the impression that Adonis is not comfortable on the inside. There it is again. Oh, he just caught Adonis with an uppercut on the inside. Okay, and now Williams is dancing. Hey, I'm gonna tell you guys something right now. Adonis Stevens is not comfortable on the inside. It's funny how I keep telling you guys that he reminds me of Manny Pacquiao. Just like Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao, he has a really good left hand, and Manny Pacquiao, he makes up for his mistakes and his flaws with his left hand. But Manny Pacquiao, he does not fight on the inside. That's exactly what I just seen in round two with Adonis Stevenson. Once Williams got on the inside, Adonis Stevenson, he looked like a fish out of water. So this fight is shaping up to be good. Am I behind again, y'all? Am I behind again? Let me go ahead and here. Let me see if I rewound this. Hold on 1 second, y'all. Hold on. Let me make sure. Where's the goddamn controller? Okay, y'all. Okay. Okay, y'all. All right. So, yeah, I think I was a couple seconds behind. So let's see here. Let me make sure I'm live now. Okay, you guys. You guys at 2 minutes and about 23 seconds right now, right? I want to make sure because 2:30. Okay, that was a second. We got y'all got the fight. Hey y'all, this is shaping up to be a real good fight. Oh! Williams is throwing some power shots, y'all. Williams just came. He just caught Adonis with another good right hook, backed him up with a three-punch combination. I'm telling you, man, Adonis is good. But Adonis is not an inside fighter. He has no inside game. And right now, he's controlling. Right now, Adonis is on the outside. He's controlling. Oh, he's controlling Williams with the jab. But when Williams gets close, Adonis has no answers on the inside. And see, guys, this is what makes a complete fighter, man. This is what makes a complete fighter. A fighter that knows how to fight on the inside and on the outside. A fighter who can box. They can brawl. You know, they have angles. Adonis is a fish out of water when he's on the inside. When Williams gets close to this man, Adonis has no answers. All he does is block. All Adonis does is block once Williams gets close. He does not know how to work on the inside. That's a problem for Adonis. That he just landed a good left hand. See, he landed a good left hand, but once again, once Williams gets past the left hand, Adonis is vulnerable, guys. Yeah, Adonis better be careful. He says Stevenson getting tired. Hey, if you guys can't find the fight on the internet and if it's not working, if you do have cable, it's on free TV, so it's not. Oh, he just caught Adonis with an uppercut, but Adonis came right back. Wow. Hey, Adonis is showing a good chin. Now Adonis hurt him with an uppercut. Oh shit. Oh boy. It's going down, y'all. Oh, man, this is a good fight, guys. PBC, y'all, on Spike TV. Main event, Adonis Williams versus Thomas Williams, top dog Thomas Williams. Hey, this is a good fight, guys. Adonis can take a punch, guys. And Williams has a good chance. Oh, wow. He caught Stevenson with a good right hook. Uppercut, right uppercut. That was a left uppercut. They show in a replay. Adonis caught top dog with a nice uppercut. You know what's crazy is Adonis Williams, he actually caught Adonis with an uppercut first, but it didn't hurt Adonis. Adonis came right back, and then he actually hurt Williams with his uppercut. You guys think Stevens is getting tired? How's Williams' stamina? Well, you know what? I mean, I haven't really seen too many Williams fights at least go the distance. I mean, the fights that I've seen, they were pretty short. So I don't really know how good his stamina is. But I'll tell you right now, I mean, you know, Williams is not throwing a whole lot of punches. So if he does get tired, it'll most likely be from anxiety. But he's not throwing a whole lot of punches. But then again, he's throwing a lot of haymakers, though. And I'm telling you guys right now, this is a good-ass fight. Oh, now look, now Adonis, he came in. He went right on the inside. Now Adonis is trying to fight on the inside. Oh, it's a low blow? Okay. Okay, they're calling it a low blow. Hey, right when I said Adonis Stevenson, he can't fight on the inside. Adonis, he went in at the beginning of the round, and he went right on the inside, and he did it the way you're supposed to. He came in with the high guard. He went low, like kind of like a little bit of a bob and weave, and he tried to catch Williams with an uppercut to the body, but it was a little bit of a low blow. Look, Adonis fighting the inside game. It's an inside fight now. They're going back and forth. They're exchanging. Williams is throwing hard, hellacious hooks, man, but Adonis is walking through it. Oh, this is a good fight, guys. This is a good fight. They're going toe-to-toe, y'all. They're going toe-to-toe right now. Oh, man. Adonis just caught him with another good left hand and two good left hooks to the body. Oh, this is good, guys. This is good. Toe-to-toe in the center of the ring right now. Adonis is investing. He's investing in those body shots. And I just looked at Williams' face, and he had a look of uncertainty. Oh, man, Adonis is starting to – he's starting to take the air out of them tires. He's starting to take the air out of those tires with them body shots right now. Williams – hey, look, Williams does not look as sure anymore. Oh, nice uppercut by Adonis. Adonis is walking Williams down. This is impressive, guys. Adonis is walking down the power puncher, and now Williams is complaining again. Hey, I'm telling y'all, Williams is looking for a way out of this fight, guys. He's just complaining to the referee about nothing. I just told you guys a minute ago that he looked uncertain of himself. He looks deterred. Williams is ready to go, guys. He doesn't like the body shots. He's tired, and he's about to get knocked out. And now Adonis is pouring it on him right now. Uppercuts by Adonis. Body shots. Body shots. Body shots. Uppercuts. Adonis is about to knock this man out. And if Adonis gets this knockout, guys, this will be a very impressive performance. Oh, nice. Oh, little Tyson combination. Adonis threw a left hook to the body and a left uppercut he followed up with. That was a Mike Tyson combo. Oh, now Williams is holding. I told you guys. Williams is ready to go, guys. Williams is ready to go. Adonis has beat this man at his own game. Uppercut, body shot, uppercut, body shot, uppercut, body shot. Oh, he keeps backing him. Oh, he just, oh! That's it? That's it? Oh, my goodness. I told you. I told you. I told you. He walked that man down. Oh, he walked that man down. He walked that man down. Live right now. He knocked it. He knocked. I told y'all. I told you. Hey, man, I give this man, Adonis Stevenson, a lot of credit. This man is even better than I thought he was. He showed an inside game. I started this off. At the beginning of this fight, I started this off saying Adonis doesn't have an inside game. Two rounds later, Adonis went on the inside. He said, forget this outside game. I'm going to show this man I could beat him on the inside. And he just broke this man down with body shots. You could see the discouragement in Williams' face when he started letting him body shots. Here's the replay. The replay, he has him on the ropes. Vicious. Vicious short left hand. Vicious short left hand. It was kind of like a left hand, left hook. Hey, y'all, I'm going to tell you right now, I used to pick Kovalev to beat Adonis. After what I just seen right now, I pick Adonis to beat Sergey Kovalev. This was an impressive performance by Adonis Stevens. Something else Adonis did, guys, is he showed a chin. This dude, listen, let me tell you something. Williams caught Adonis with some really good hooks. Adonis took all of his best punches. Once Adonis started fighting on the inside, it was a wrap. It was a wrap. Excellent performance by Adonis Stevenson. I'm really impressed. I'm really impressed. Yes, Adonis is a bad boy. Flawless victory, my man LK said. I'm telling you guys right now, I'm pretty sure that Adonis, he would beat Kovalev. Now, he won't beat Andre Ward. He ain't going to beat Andre Ward, but he can beat Kovalev. And he will probably beat Better Biev as well. But Adonis Stevenson has another tough fight, which is against a leader, Alvarez. Yeah, he walked through him. This was an excellent performance by Adonis Stevenson. He showed every aspect of his game and more. The fact that he was able to fight on the inside, he was able to fight on the outside. He took all of William's best punches, his best shots, and he walked him down. Adonis Stevenson, he walked down the aggressor. Yeah, I'll be honest with you. I thought Kovalev had an edge over Kovalev before this performance. After watching this performance, there's no doubt about it. I agree with you guys. I would pick Adonis over Kovalev in a heartbeat. Nobody beats Andre Ward, but I would pick him over Kovalev. This was impressive. This was impressive. Yeah, man. Yeah, this was an impressive performance. I can't believe he, like I said, once again, he took the shots. He took William's best shots. He went toe-to-toe with the guy. His inside game was impeccable. For a fighter who usually doesn't fight on the inside, here, hold on, let me listen to what he has to say. Yeah, he's talking about it. He said when you have two power punches in there, you put on a show, of course. The fact that Adonis Stevenson did this to a knockout artist, he walked down a knockout artist and backed him up. That's what made this so impressive. That's pretty much like, I'm not saying Williams was Mike Tyson, but that's like walking down Mike Tyson. You take away a person's best weapon and you walk them down. He broke this man down with body shots, uppercuts, and aggression. He beat him on the outside and he beat him on the inside. He beat him at his own game. Very impressive performance. Very impressive performance. You know, it was looking like, for a minute, it was looking like Williams was about to actually get back into the fight because Williams was getting comfortable on the inside. But then all of a sudden, once again, Adonis, he surprised me by beating this guy at his own game and fighting him on the inside. I like the Mike Tyson combinations. He throws the left hook, uppercut. And that was impressive. Yeah, this was, what do you say? You say he was too huge? Oh, I already know. Oh, we already know. You don't even have to respond to, we already know the decabs is in here. They're not talking boxing. They on that decab racial shit. I'm probably about to block, you know, all the undertone race talk. I'm gonna go ahead and delete the undertone racial talk because we over here talking boxing. Matter of fact, let me go ahead and delete this dude. Let me just get him out of here because we over here talking boxing. We don't need no distractions when we talking boxing. I love this block button. Watch this. Bam, that motherfucker blocked. Oh, I love this block button. Oh yeah, gone. So anyway, back to boxing talk. Yeah, man. So once again, very impressive performance by ADONIS Stevenson. Vicious knockout. And I look forward to seeing him go against, hold on, y'all. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. DeKalb will roast Stevenson regardless. Oh, yeah, but the bottom line is they're not talking boxing, though. The DeKalb ain't talking boxing, Warren, so it really don't matter. We over here talking boxing. If we go to the boxing gym and we talk to some boxing trainers and some boxers, this is how they're going to talk, like real knowledgeable boxing fans and boxing heads. When did I start doing live footage? Where that? Okay. I just started doing it today. This is the first time I did it. Who should ADONIS fight? ADONIS, he has to fight his mandatory next. That's the undefeated guy that was on the undercard tonight. That's Aleider Alvarez. That's another tough fight for ADONIS. So, you know what's funny is ADONIS, his ADONIS road this year is going to be almost as tough as Ward and Kovalev's, because he just had to beat Williams, which was a tough opponent. And then after that, he has to fight the undefeated Aleider Alvarez. So, it's some good fights. Oh, yeah, I'm definitely watching Leo tomorrow. I'm definitely watching them, and I may be on here live again. Leo Santa Cruz against Carl Frampton tomorrow, guys. Block No Name. Is that another one of the races? Because we blocking all the racist stuff, all the undertones that they use, the code words. If I see any code words, anything like that, you getting blocked. They make it too easy to block people on here. I'm liking this. I mean, man, I'm quick on the draw, too. Yeah, we gonna. No, oh, yeah, okay. I'm gonna block this dude. Yeah, I think I remember this dude. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and block this dude right here. Yeah, we getting him out of here. Yeah, the block game is in effect. Yeah, the block game is in effect. Ain't no field goals tonight. The block game is in effect. You getting that shit slammed in your face. What's going on, y'all? What's going on? Oh no, yeah. When they say he's on pads, what they really want to say is, you know, that's an N-word and that's so-and-so and I basically don't like him. You guys got to read the undertones. You got to read the codes. You got to decipher what they really are trying to say. You know what I mean? Because when they get knockouts, you know what I'm saying? When someone on the hopeless gets knockouts, you know, he's a bad, you know, motherfucker. But when someone on a coincidental list gets knockouts, now he's cheating. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. What up with John Pascal? John Pascal, man, John Pascal, he done took a lot of punches in the last couple fights, man. He may need a layoff. I don't know. You know, I mean, he may have went as far as he can go in the game. You know, I hate to say it, but as much as I like John Pascal, you know, he's probably a gatekeeper now. You know, they'll start throwing him in there with the young undefeated fighters. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You already know for life. You already know how it goes, man. When you're on a coincidental list, the more successful you are, the more hated you are. You see ADONIS, he gets this knockout, and then all of a sudden the DeKalb start making up shit. He's on pads, this and that, et cetera, et cetera. We know what those cold words really mean. We know what them cold words really mean. Is ADONIS the best light heavyweight? I don't know about that, Shogun. I think Andre Ward, even though he just moved up to light heavyweight, I think Andre Ward is the best light heavyweight right now. I think he's going to beat Sergey Kovalev, and I think Stevenson, he will beat Kovalev as well. But he ain't going to beat Andre Ward. Ain't nobody beating Andre Ward, according to the Twitter. Yeah, Ward is the best. That's what I said. What do you think about GG versus B-Hop? You know, Sean, that's actually a good fight. Even at 50 years old, I think Bernard Hopkins versus Gennady Golovkin would be a really good fight. Now, I would have to lean towards Golovkin just because of the youth. But if you were talking about the 40-year-old, not even the 30-year-old Bernard Hopkins, you put the 40-year-old B-Hop in there, and I think he beats and probably stops Gennady Golovkin. I think he breaks him down and hurts him just like he did Felix Trinidad. I think Ward, Adonis, and Kovalev can all beat each other. What's that? B-Hop's performance. Oh, yeah. Hopkins' performance against Trinidad was definitely epic. No doubt about it. Who you got winning between Carl Frampton? Man, that's a tough pick, guys. I'm not real confident with my pick. But I'm going with Carl Frampton. I think Carl Frampton is the better boxer, better defense. But Leo Santa Cruz, he showed improvements in his boxing ability against Abner Mares. You know, he controlled Abner Mares with his jab and his distance. So I was impressed with that. Hold on one quick second, guys. Just hold on for a second. Hold on, y'all. One quick second. All right, I'm back. I'm back. Ward and Crawford is a bad comparison. Who's comparing Ward to Crawford? Everyone hit the thumbs up button, y'all. I heard that. Leo needs to fight Rigo. Yeah, you know that ain't gonna happen. Don't even use the R word or name around Leo Santa Cruz. Don't even use that word around him. Don't even say that name or don't even say R around Leo Santa Cruz. I'm telling you that right now. They ain't trying to mess with Rigo. They ain't trying to mess with Rigo. Take back. I'm not sure. I was planning on going to Oakland for the Ward versus Brand fight. I was planning on going out there. I'm not sure if I'm gonna make it now because I have some other things I gotta take care of. Yeah, Rigo beats Leo and Frampton. Of course, that's why they didn't take the fight. That's why they didn't take the fight. Is GG the bum beater code word for cracker? Oh, they over here clowning. They over here clowning. Oh, this is one of the decals right here. Oh, this is one of the decals. We got a decal on here. Okay. Okay. Well, let me ask you, Christian. What would you call Golovkin beating Willie Monroe and Adama? Let me go ahead and ask you that. What would you call it? Oh yeah. Oh, we know they trolling. What's going on, Marquise? Marquise in the building. What's going on? I want to hear what this decaf is gonna say. We got one of the decafs. He was basically telling us not to criticize Golovkin's competition. So I want him to answer his mandatory. Willie Monroe wasn't his mandatory. Willie Monroe wasn't his mandatory. Adama wasn't his mandatory. Rubio wasn't his mandatory either. Gigi has not proven himself And at the same time, you can't say, okay, the comment just went up. You can't say he's bad either. No, Gigi is a great fighter. Gigi is a hell of a fighter. Gigi has tremendous skills, but we have to see him in the ring. We have to see him tested. We have to see him deal with adversity. We have to see him in a Thurman Porter type of fight. We have to see, how does he deal with a cut? How does he deal with being hurt with a shot? How does he rally back? That's what we need to see with Gennady Golovkin. Now, does that make sense or does that not make sense? We well know. Oh, For Life, I already know For Life. That's happened to me a couple times. I actually debated with a decaf one time about the Pacquiao Mayweather fight. He told me how the fight was boring, it was this and that. We talked for a good 15 minutes. Do you know this motherfucker had the audacity to tell me he never even watched the fight? He just heard from his friends. That is what you call a real decaf, a dumb casual ass fan right there. He never even watched the fight. Because why? Because it's therapeutic for them to say these things. They don't care if it makes sense or not. They just want to say it because they have this racial bias agenda. Well, how did Pacquiao have a bad shoulder when Bob Arum and Floyd Mayweather, Bob Arum and Manny Pacquiao, they said that their shoulder was okay going into the fight? First they actually said their shoulder was hurt before the fight. And then when they found out they were getting sued, then they said, oh, no, we changed our mind. Our shoulder was okay, and then it was injured in the fourth round. But then you see Manny Pacquiao continue to throw his left hand even after the fourth round. If you guys want to see a real shoulder injury, I want you to go back and watch Andre Berto. When Andre Berto injured his shoulder, he couldn't even lift it up, and he fought with one hand. That's a real injured shoulder. Or watch John Pascal. When John Pascal hurt his shoulder, that is what you call a shoulder injury.
It was only like a Mayweather fight.
Of course, that's what they want to see. That's how it works. You know, that's how it works when you're on a coincidental list. The more successful you are, the more hated you are. The more unsuccessful you are, the more they like you. You guys ever notice that? When fighters on a coincidental list, you ever notice when they lose, that's when they're liked the most? This really happens in the UFC. When Rashad Evans, when Rampage, when they were the best, after Rampage beat, Chuck Liddell, they hated the shit out of him. Soon as Rampage lost, then they started to cheer. But I don't want to talk too much about the MMA. But the coincidental list, it goes far beyond boxing. You know, that's just a part of life. We already know that. We know what time it is. Billy Joe Saunders. You guys believe that, let me see. They had watered down decaffeinated. Okay, they watered down and decaffeinated. I heard that. We know what time it is. So, do you guys believe that Canelo, they said Canelo, he might fight BJ Saunders next? I don't know if that would happen, but I tell you, if Canelo moves up and he fights BJ Saunders, that would be pretty impressive. That would be pretty impressive, you know, because at least he's fighting against the middleweight. Okay, we got some more decaps in here. Let's talk some boxing. We got decaps just using code words. We know what them code words mean. JVB. We know what them code words mean. Ward is overhyped. We already know what the code words is. We can translate it, but I ain't gonna even use those nasty words. Canelo versus Billy Ho is coming next. Oh, Jay, you know, Jay, he's just using his code words. We already translated it. We know what that means. We know what the code words are. Felix Tito murders Canelo. Oh, my God. Whoa, well, that would have been a great fight. Oh, yeah. Trinidad, he would have walked down Canelo and knocked him out, no doubt about it. But in all reality, I don't think that Canelo would have ever fought Trinidad. Canelo, he'll fight Canelo, he'll fight Cotto, but he would have never fought a Trinidad in his prime, I don't think. Oh, the dude is just trolling. Okay. All right, Jay. If you're right, then I will say that you know a little bit about boxing. Now, if you're wrong, then we know you were just trolling. What age did Vargas fight Trinidad? I don't remember the exact age. Big Spell said 24. I know it was around something. It was around that age. It was somewhere around that age. Canelo versus Matthew Hilton. Are you talking about Matthew Hatton? Okay, break it down. All right, I'm gonna let Jay break it down. You know when you just say someone is gonna win and you don't explain why, you just keep saying no way Ward is gonna win. Explain it. Break it down. Give us a breakdown. Give us the tell of the tape. Give us Kovalev's advantages versus Ward's disadvantages. Let us know what Ward's flaws are, and let us know what Kovalev's flaws and his advantages are. But when you just come flat out and say, hey, man, you know, Kovalev's going to whoop Ward's ass, and there's no way Ward can win, you say that kind of stuff, you look like a troll. You look like you're not even talking boxing. So if you believe that Kovalev is going to beat Ward, which I'm not saying it's impossible because it's not impossible, just explain it. Break it down. If I tell you the reason why Rigo is going to beat Leo Santa Cruz, I'm going to break it down. I'm not going to give you some, you know, ridiculous ass troll type of response. What's going on, y'all? What's going on? What is that? Kovalev has some rhythm, but he's a little robotic. Yeah, my man, what's going on, Marquise? My man, Marquise, you're absolutely right. He does have some rhythm. Kovalev is a good fighter. And Kovalev, he would beat the majority of fighters in the division, I believe. But against Andre Ward has too much rhythm for him. And Andre Ward, he has an inside game. Kovalev is not comfortable on the inside. Kovalev, if you look at him against Chilimba, he was fighting against a very slow, you know, fighter that was nowhere near on the level of an Andre Ward. Ike Chilimba was able to catch Kovalev with some slow-ass telegraph left hooks and right hands. Ike Chilimba was controlling Kovalev with a jab. So there's no way he would beat Andre Ward. I don't believe it. In order for him to beat Andre Ward, he would have to land one vicious right hand, and Ward would either get knocked out or he would not be able to recover from that one right hand. I don't see Kovalev. I don't see Kovalev beating Andre Ward. Yeah, but the second testing sample was supposed to come out, then nothing. Okay, Williams could have KO'd Kobe. Oh, no doubt about it, with some of those shots. No doubt about it. Let me tell you something. What I like about what Adonis Stevenson did tonight against Thomas Top Dog Williams is he beat Top Dog at his own game. He fought him on the inside. And that's exactly what he would have to do against someone like Kovalev. He couldn't deal with Chilimba jab. Yeah, Marquise, you're absolutely right. He couldn't deal with his jab. You're absolutely right. Wilder versus Joshua. Chris, what's going on, Chris? Wilder versus Joshua, that is a tough fight, guys. That's a tough fight. I used to think before Wilder had no chance against Anthony Joshua. Now, you know, I'm almost leaning towards Deontay Wilder because I think Anthony Joshua has problems with foot movement and athleticism. And the fact that Deontay Wilder can land that right hand all the way from the other side of the ropes or the other side of the ring, that gives him a very good chance against someone like Anthony Joshua. I think Anthony Joshua would be almost gun-shy with the power that Deontay Wilder has. Don't get me wrong. They'll both have respect for each other, but I think Joshua would have more respect for Wilder than vice versa. Some of my favorite fights, Chavez versus Frankie Randall, Felix Trinidad against Fernando Vargas. Let me see. I like Pernell Whitaker versus Jorge Paez. Those are some of my favorite fights. Shane Mosley versus De La Hoya was a good one. It's a lot of them. It's a lot of them. I go kind of way back when it comes to some of my favorite fights. I was going to go. You going to go out there, Marquise? You going to go out there to Oakland, to the Bay Area for that Ward versus Brand fight? Shane Mosley versus Felix Trinidad. That would have been a hell of a fight. That would have been a hell of a fight. So, yeah, guys, we just hanging out. I'm hanging out with the fans right now after another great fight on PBC. ADONIS STEVENSON, he knocks out Thomas Top Dog Williams. Very impressive performance. What you doing? Nah, given quality, he ain't going to be impressed because that's not what he's coming here for. He was coming over here to make a decaf statement. He's not trying to make any sense of this. You know, if Ward beats Kovalev, he'll say some more ridiculous stuff, just like some troll that I had to block just said after ADONIS just knocked out Williams. You know, it's funny because these decafs, they always ask for knockouts. They say, we want to see knockouts, and that's why so-and-so on a coincidental list is not like. But then once they get knockouts, that's when they start to complain, and they say, oh, you know, steroids, PEDs, and, you know, he cheated, et cetera, et cetera. So we know what time it is. I don't know if Mark Breland trains other fighters outside of Deontay Wilder. Garcia versus Salka. Yep, Garcia versus Salka, that's a classic, absolutely. Is Danny Garcia the biggest cherry picker in boxing? I wouldn't go that far. I wouldn't go that far and say he's the biggest cherry picker. You know, you have some other fighters right now that I think they take that title hands down. Luis Ortiz is very smart. Luis Ortiz is the most avoided heavyweight in the heavyweight division right now. Out of all the Eastern European fighters, Lomachenko is the real deal. Huge fan of his game. No doubt about it. Lomachenko, he probably is the most skilled. But at the same time, he did lose against Orlando Salido. And we have to see if that was just a bad day or does he have problems with inside fighters. Inside fighters, you know, unorthodox fighters. Not only was Salido an inside fighter, but he was also moving away from Lomachenko. And he forced Lomachenko to actually come after him. And then out of nowhere, Salido, he would come in with an ambush attack and he would surprise Lomachenko. So we got to see how he does against a fighter like that. Joshua beats Wilder. Joshua has more skill. Anything is possible. What do you think of Grant Gloves looking extra small? At the end of the day, you know, as long as these gloves are the same weight and you know, when you put them on a scale, they weigh the same amount. We all know Grant Gloves, they're not known as the puncher gloves. You know, they're still not known as the puncher gloves. Reyes gloves have always been known as the puncher gloves. But from what I've seen Mike Tyson knock out people in Grant Gloves, Reyes gloves. It really doesn't matter. So I don't think it makes that much of a difference unless you're wearing Maidana Grant Gloves. What do you think about Garcia versus Berto? Garcia versus Berto is a really good fight. You know, I would not be surprised. I would lean towards Garcia in that fight. I think he would knock out Berto, but Berto has this type of deceptive, sneaky power, and if he catches you, he can hurt you. That's why Floyd Mayweather was respecting him almost more than Floyd Mayweather respected Manny Pacquiao. You said Top Dog's new name is Low Dog. Willie Pep versus Floyd Mayweather, that would be an extremely easy fight for Floyd Mayweather, because Floyd Mayweather, whenever Floyd fights against boxers, Floyd is the aggressor. You watch Floyd against Zab Judah, Charmaine Mitchell, Shane Mosley, a couple other cats. Floyd Mayweather is a lot more aggressive. Floyd Mayweather has said it himself: you bang the boxer and you box the banger. So he would run over someone like a Willie Pep. Willie Pep doesn't have the natural athleticism or head movement to get away from a Floyd Mayweather. All Willie Pep used for defense was foot movement. That's not enough to get away from Floyd, because Floyd, he knows how to cut off the ring in a great way, just like he did against Zab Judah. All right, guys. Well, I'm going to get ready to wrap this up. I want to say thanks to all you guys for tuning in and leaving all the comments. We'll do this a lot more often in the future. That's pretty much all I got for now. I'll catch up with you guys. I'm on to the next one, guys. All right, y'all. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I don't even know how to stop this shit. I got to figure out how to stop this shit. Damn, where did that damn... Jesus Christ. What's going on, y'all? Okay. All right, y'all. I catch up with y'all. I'm on to the next one. We'll do this again real soon, y'all. I'll probably be on here tomorrow. So check me out tomorrow, guys. Tomorrow on the, Leo Santa Cruz versus Carl Frampton fight. We'll hang out and talk some more boxing tomorrow, y'all. On to the next one.